Welcome to the third part of 6 methods to join strings in an Excel sheet. In the previous videos, we have seen how to join strings using concatenate function, ampersand operator, macros and user defined functions. In this particular video, concat function and text join function for joining strings are explained. In the previous videos, we have seen how to join text using concatenate function, ampersand operator, macros and user defined functions. This third video is about concat and text join functions in Excel. Please note that these functions are only available with the 2019 or higher versions of Excel. To combine the text present in the cells B2 to B6 equal concat function, click on insert function. Here you can see the purpose of the function concatenates a list or range of text strings. Here you can specify the text to be concatenated. Text1 will be B2, text2 will be B3, B4, B5 and B6. And here you can see the formula result. We have seen the case of individual values. Now with a range of cells. This is the major difference between concatenate function and concat function. Concatenate function is meant to work with individual cells and not with data ranges. Equal concat C2 to C6. Once again with a range of cells. Equal concat B2 to C6. Here you can see the function will concatenate the values like A1, B1, A2, B2 in the order of values present in each row. That is, function concatenated the values present in row number 2, then row number 3 up to row number 6. But if you want the function to consider values in the order of columns, we can specify it in the function. Equal concat B2 to B6, comma C2 to C6. Now it's A1 up to A5, then B1 to B5. Now the use of text join function. Equal text join. You can see the purpose of text join function here. It says concatenates a list or range of text strings using a delimiter. The delimiter can be any character from a space, comma or asterisk. Whatever we specify as a delimiter will be put in between each values we join using this text join function. Insert function. You can see three parameters here. First one is delimiter. We'll specify the delimiter space. Second parameter is ignore empty cells. If we specify true here, empty cells will be ignored. Use of this parameter will be explained later in this video with an example. Now the third parameter, text1. Here we have to specify the strings to be joined. G2, G3, G4, G5. And G6. And here you can see the formula result. We have combined the values from A1 to A5 using text join function with a space between each. Now we will try this text join function with a range of cells. Equal text join. Double quotes space double quotes comma true comma H2 to H6. Once more with a data range containing two columns, we'll use a different delimiter here. Let it be hyphen, text join, double quotes, hyphen, double quotes, comma, true, comma, G2 to H6. To process the cells in the order of columns, text join. We'll use a different delimiter here, double quotes, asterisk, double quotes, comma, true, comma, G2 to G6, comma, H2 to H6. Now about the use of the second parameter in text join function, that is ignore empty cells. Here in the cell L8, I will use the same formula which we used in the cell J8, but with a different value for the second parameter. The second parameter ignore empty cells will be false here. You can see the results in L8 and J8 are similar. But if I delete some cells in between, you can see the difference. In the cell J8, text join function ignores the empty cells in the range from G2 to H6, and the result is A1-B1-A5-B5. But in the cell L8, the text join function is considering each and every cells in the range from G2 to G6 and is providing a delimiter in between values present in each cell. So the result is A1-B1, then a series of hyphens, then A5-B5. Now an example for the use of concat and text join functions. I will combine these first, middle and last names present in this sheet using concat and text join functions. Equal concat B2 comma double quotes space double quotes comma C2 comma double quotes space double quotes comma D2. Equal text join double quotes space double quotes comma true for ignoring the empty cells comma then P2 to D2, the range of cells to be joined. If you watch this closely, when I joined Judith Polgar using concat function, the result has two spaces in between first and last names. But with text join function, the result is just perfect. The workbook shown in this video can be downloaded from my blog. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you won't miss any video releases. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.